Greetings, traders, and welcome back to another In-Depth with Chris episode. In today's discussion, we will be answering a hard-hitting question. That question is, why do gas prices fluctuate so darn much? This is a question that is asked both by traders as well as non-traders alike. So however you found the video, well, welcome aboard. Please do me a favor if you haven't, click that like and subscribe button down below so I can keep coming out with content for you all out there. But without further ado, let's get going. Despite being an integral aspect of everyday living, most people don't understand why the money needed to fuel their cars rises and falls so frequently. If you find yourself in the category, well, today's discussion is exactly for you. The first thing that we'll cover are the impacting factors. When COVID-19, when the pandemic first hit, everyone hunkered down at their home, effectively plunging the demand for gas. Prices were at all-time lows as a result of this. However, barely a year later, gas prices are climbing back up and with a vengeance. Now, we're steadily seeing prices rise cent by cent, and really, it only took 3 months for gas to jump from $2.24 a gallon in the US to $2.90 in May, and that is very, very short for such a steep incline. The most common reason we should care about the fluctuating or rising prices is simply in our daily commute. If you stop and think about how much it costs you weekly to fill up your vehicle as part of your daily or weekly process of getting from A to B, how has that changed in the last couple months? Chances are it's probably risen, and it's probably risen somewhat substantially. Fluctuating gas prices can also provide insight for investors in the oil and energy industries. Gas is a commodity, after all. A rise in prices correlates with higher economic activity to a certain degree. A dip can be an indication of a lull in economic activities, as was the case when the coronavirus rampage was at its peak in 2020. According to the U.S. Energy Information Administration, which we know as the EIA, the main driver of gas prices is the cost of crude oil. The remainder is a combination of refining costs, marketing and distribution, taxation policies, and changes in the value of the U.S. dollar. So that's what we'll talk about to give a little bit of a clearer picture around this correlation. Consumers may buy gasoline locally, but fuel prices primarily depend on how crude oil is performing in the global market. When crude oil prices change, the end consumer feels it in the prices that they are paying at the pump. The EIA estimates that fluctuating crude oil prices account for more than half of fluctuations in gas prices themselves. So what causes fluctuations in crude oil prices then? The three main factors in that area begin with market demand and supply. On April 20th, 2020, U.S. oil prices were negative for the first time ever as everyone was forced indoors and the demand dried up. U.S. oil benchmark West Texas Intermediate, which is WTI, started the day at a new low of $17.85. But by the close of trading, it had fallen all the way to negative $37.63. With little to no demand, supply was at an all-time high. Oil vessels and tankers were left stranded with nowhere to deliver products, hence the negative price being something of a possibility due to the cost of storage. This chart is just one of many examples of how market demand and supply can destabilize crude oil prices, which ripples in effect to influence the prices of gas, diesel, kerosene, and other end products. Commodity trading is an excellent way for speculators to turn a nice profit with the help of crude oil price fluctuations, but also can contribute to them. Because of this interplay, crude oil as a commodity is subject to market fluctuations. With speculative trading, the futures market records increased liquidity. The speculators think the price of crude oil will rise or drop in the future, so they enter the contract based on the direction they expect. For example, prices tend to rise during the summer because that's when travel picks up. So speculators can start buying futures contracts in the spring or even winter to anticipate the summer rise. The result is a massive incentive in the production and storage of crude oil to rise and meet that increased demand. So as such, speculation also plays its role in the markets. Another large factor in the generation of prices as well as the cause of price fluctuations comes down to the refining costs and the profits. Crude oil is only the base product and is relatively unusable as is. The gasoline that we pump into our car or machinery has undergone specialized refining. And as we would probably imagine, refinery operations are not cheap, and mainly this is due to the fact that most refineries are situated offshore even. The maintenance costs alone are quite astronomical. An example of this would be just taking a look at Nigeria's refineries, where their costs are over $26.5 billion just in the maintenance department. The companies running these refineries are in it for profit, as you would imagine, so their margins have to be competitive as well. They add their margins on top of the price, with the end users picking up the tab. Seasonality also plays a crucial role in determining the cost of refining crude oil. During the cold months, production tends to drop as demand dwindles, but then picks up during summer to meet rising demand. The price of crude oil is therefore affected during these months. Retail oil prices typically include the cost of transporting the gasoline to the depots and pump stations across the country. The marketing expenses incurred by the oil companies are also passed directly onto the consumers, so these are other things to also keep in mind, that there are distribution and marketing costs that the consumer will ultimately be paying and funding as well. Federal, state, and local government taxes all also influence retail gas prices. And looking at this graph, we can see a quick breakdown of the taxes, or the sales taxes and other fees, that are charged and levied by local and municipal governments across the United States. The U.S. average of gasoline taxes, when we combine the local, state, and federal rates, gives us an average of 54.57 across the country. Take a look around and see how your individual state fares. While we're aware that there are many reasons why gas prices may differ from state to state, one of the primary reasons that retail gas prices differ is due to the fact that they are generally more expensive the farther they are sold from the primary point of supply. These include the refineries, product pipelines, shipping ports, blending depots, and so on and so forth. The underlying reason is that these remote areas have to pay much higher transportation costs, which then in turn are going to be covered by the individual at the pump. Some other reasons include differences in provincial tax on gasoline in different areas. These taxes vary from one municipality to the other, but you can be sure that your wallet will, in essence, bear the cost. There's also fixed operating costs. Gas stations in some small towns and remote areas aren't selling as much gas as their counterparts in the big cities, and yet they have fixed costs that they need to cover, so they might feel inclined to sell their gas at a higher point in order to cover that. And then there's also the effect of competition. Some regional areas have more gas stations than others. This amps up the competition within the players looking to lower their prices in order to maintain that competitive edge over their counterparts. Another contributing factor is the fact that there's also additional gas station services, which are when some gas stations offer add-on value services like a car wash or a convenience store. These services do bring in extra income to afford to lower their gas prices even further. So the bottom line is, regardless of who you are and whether you care about trading or not, we're all impacted by gasoline price fluctuations or oil price fluctuations one way or another. There is that trickling effect, even if you don't notice it in the immediate consumption of whatever it is that you're buying. And because all of us are impacted, we should take an interest in understanding what causes those price fluctuations, so perhaps we can plan more accordingly, whether it's through investing or just planning a summer vacation. But until next time, thank you for joining me. As always, folks, if you haven't, please do me a favor, click that like and subscribe button down below before you go, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers, guys.